The few moments of elementary financial literacy. Whatever your income, 10% of your income should be set aside for unpredictable, unforeseen events. Secondly, you should live within your means. You should not borrow now in order to pay back later. This is about consumer loans. Look at how many people think that they are much bigger than they really are. That they can afford a more expensive TV, take an additional debt and pay for it with difficulty. Why do people live like this? Because people are weak, weak from temptations. It is on this that all the advertising of such a consumer way of existence is built, for the persecution of people on credit. The bank really needs slaves who constantly bring money to the banks. I'm telling you to put 10% of your income into your reserve fund. And where do you send 10% of your income? To pay for a loan to the bank. Why did you do that? Because you wanted to buy a bigger TV or a bigger car. You wanted to live now, and you paid for it with your future. And this is only the first step. When you, instead of forming a contingency fund for yourself, you will give 10% to the bank. And now you've lost your job, you can't pay the loan to the bank, and the bank has taken this car, apartment from you. By the way, there is a wonderful experiment about marshmallows. It is called the marshmallow test. They put the children in, and tell them, if you don't eat this marshmallow in half an hour, we'll give you another one. You'll eat two later. It would seem reasonable to wait for half an hour, endure, and you will be given two marshmallows. But when adults come out after 1, 2, 3 minutes, most children eat this marshmallow. Then, after 15, 20 years, they measured what happened to these children. It turns out that those children who had patience and waited for half an hour in their life turned out better. In our head, there are so-called areas of the cerebral cortex that are responsible for the delay. Our ability to delay our desires. A lot of students were engaged in business in our hostel. There was nothing to eat, forced entrepreneurs started doing business. Who was lucky, money appeared, students were divided into two types. The first ones did not include any delay at all. They immediately got cars, apartments, restaurants, girls. And there were students like me who didn't have any of this at all, but really wanted to. Some part of the head sent all our money, efforts, focus of attention, concentration to a new production, a new line, new technologies, to increase the geographical coverage of the business. The delay must be trained. How to train? Deny yourself what you really want. You want a bigger TV, you'll get over it. You want a bigger car, you'll get over it. Train the delay. You should not live on loan, the payment is too expensive. There is always more that is prepared for a person. Each person can earn 2 times, 3 times, and even 10 times more. At the moment when everything is stable for a person, he should think about how to earn more. If your income does not increase over time, you must find a way to change your job, business, environment. This is a very powerful financial indicator. Income either grows or you degrade. There is a very simple indicator of income growth that you can focus on. Each country has an inflation indicator. Your income should grow at about twice the rate of inflation at a minimum, there is no maximum. If you set yourself an indicator that your income should grow by 10% per year, then your income will grow 2.5 times in 10 years. There are people who have been living for years in a state where they are content with a small salary. Then people get used to it, and they can't get out of this trap any further. And attention, what are people thinking at this moment? They think that there is no job, no one pays, that it is dangerous to leave the job that is now there, otherwise you will not find another one. People convince themselves and look for 1,000 proofs among their own kind that this is so. But the fact is that at that time they are surrounded by people who agree to work for a small salary. Among them there is a belief that there is no other job. They are engaged in self-persuasion, they are looking for evidence, they find this evidence, and isolate themselves from the world of those jobs where they pay more. This is a gigantic problem of the so-called templated view of the world. We humans really think in social patterns. If we live among certain people, we absorb these patterns and think with them. Well, what other patterns can a child think who looks at adults who work for a small salary? A pack of cigarettes and a beer is such a pleasure that they have. What will happen in the head of this child? He will copy the same behavior, he will join the ranks of these people. I am Igor Rybakov, I say that look at how many professions there are where you can earn more. They tell me no, look, you're lying. A person is always looking for evidence of what he has invented for himself. People's misconceptions block opportunities to break out of this vicious circle. I, Igor Rybakov, claim that it is easier to get out of any vicious circle than it seems. A few tips for financial literacy. First, save 10% of any income that you receive. Second, your income should grow at a rate 2 times faster than inflation. The third, surround yourself with people among whom the ideas about the first two norms are templates, that is, they do not doubt the need to put 10% of income in reserve, and the second, they do not doubt that income should grow over time. These 3 moments of basic financial literacy are guaranteed to be enough to break out of poverty.